Okay, so friends, in this video we are going to discuss about the assumptions that we make while solving any solid mechanics problem or any strength of material problem. So the list of assumptions would be like any material will be considered a homogeneous material, isotropic in nature, the cross section will be taken as prismatic, the self weight of the material or the object will be neglected totally. Static equilibrium will be considered to hold true, and we are going to use static equilibrium equations as we discussed in previous video also, and the stress concentration will be neglected. Now let's take these properties one by one and we'll discuss them all. So homogeneous nature, that will mean basically if I take any object here, there is any body here, and on that body if I choose different points, let's say point A, point B and point C, then in any given direction, so in any given direction, the value of engineering property will be same at all points. So what is homogeneity? The value will be same in any given direction irrespective of the location. If I take point A, point B or point C, value will remain same in this particular direction. That is homogeneous nature. If I say isotropic nature, then in isotropic nature, the value will be same at any given point in all the directions. But if I change the location, value may change there. Okay. So basically, if I take point A here, then at point A, value is E in this direction. It will remain E in this direction also. It will remain E in this direction also. If I take point B, the value changes to E1. Then this value will remain same in all directions. So that is what we mean by isotropic nature and homogeneous nature. So guys, since there are two natures here, there can be different possibilities. There can be four different combinations of these natures. Let's discuss them. Okay, so as we learned about the homogeneous and isotropic nature, so there can be four different possibilities of any object. It can be homogeneous in nature but anisotropic, so it is not isotropic. It can be non-homogeneous in nature but it is isotropic. It can be non-homogeneous, or we call that as heterogeneous also, and anisotropic, or it can be homogeneous as well as isotropic in nature. So there are these four different possibilities for any object. In case of homogeneous but non-isotropic, so if this is my object here and if I choose a points, point A, point B and point C here, there are three points, point A, point B and point C, then the engineering property is going to be same, like because of homogeneous property, it is same in one direction at all locations. So it is E at all locations. But if I change the direction, the value will change because it is anisotropic in nature. So what will that mean? If I change the direction here at point A, the value will change to some other value, let's say E1. But since it is homogeneous, the value at this location in this direction will become E1. Value at this location in this direction will become E1. That is homogeneous but anisotropic nature. If I take non-homogeneous but isotropic nature, so what will happen here? If it is my body, again I take two points only to describe it. So it is isotropic nature. So at point A, the value will be same in all the directions. If it is E here, E here, it will remain E here. In all the directions, the value is same. But since it is non-homogeneous, if I go to this point, point B, in same direction, the value will change. So it will not remain E anymore. It will become E1. And similarly, if it is E1 here, now it is isotropic. So it will remain E1 here and it will remain E1 in this direction also. That is non-homogeneous but isotropic in nature. Now non-homogeneous and anisotropic in nature. So for this particular property, if this is my object, if I take any two points on this body, we can take multiple points also, and it is non-homogeneous, means the value is E here, value will become E1 here in this direction, and this is anisotropic, so if I change the direction here, the value will also change, so it will become E2 maybe here, and it will be different from this also, it will become E4 here. So the value is changing with respect to location as well as with respect to the direction also. Value is not constant anymore. This is most general case of any material. But we don't consider either of these cases in solid mechanics unless otherwise specified. The case that we always consider is material is homogeneous as well as isotropic in nature. Now what will that mean? If I take any object, if I take my material here, at any location, in any direction, the value of engineering property will remain same. So if this is point A, this is point B, this is point C, the value, if it is E here, it will remain E in this direction also, it will remain E in this direction also. At point A, now since it is homogeneous, the value will become E here in this direction, and since it is isotropic also, so the value will remain same in all directions. That is the basic concept behind homogeneous and isotropic nature of any object. Okay, so coming back to the list of our assumptions, we have discussed the homogeneous nature, we have discussed the isotropic nature here. Now coming to the prismatic nature, what prismatic nature means is, if I am considering a beam, if I am doing the analysis on a beam, then the area of cross section of this beam throughout its length, if it is point A, it is point B, then from point A to point B, the cross section of this beam is going to be same. So if it is rectangle here, it will remain rectangle here also, it will be rectangle here also. At any location I can take, it will remain rectangle only, and the value of those dimensions will also remain same. That is what we mean by prismatic cross section. If it is circle in nature, then it will remain circle. So if it is circle here, then the same circle will be proceeded from this end to that end. That is what we mean by prismatic cross section in nature. Now that is our third property, and fourth property is regarding no self weight. So as we had discussed earlier also in our previous video, that if this was the case, there is a roller beam, the roller support here, there is a pin support here, and if I need to make the free body diagram of this particular beam, then I will only say that there is R1 here, R2 here, and R3 here. We will not consider the weight of beam unless it is specified in the question that we need to consider it. So unless otherwise specified, we are going to neglect the self weight of the beam. That is our next property. Then fifth property is static equilibrium equations. So as we discussed in previous video, static equilibrium equations sigma f is equal to 0 and sigma m is equal to 0 are going to hold true throughout our study of solid mechanics. And then sixth property is there is no stress concentration. Now this concept is new to maybe all of you, and we are going to discuss this concept in detail when we take a machine design course. So for now I will only tell you that if the area changes suddenly, so if that is the cross section of any shaft basically, so from here to here at the no change, stress will get concentrated, stress will get accumulated. But when we are doing a solid mechanics analysis, we are going to neglect that stress concentration at these notches. At all the notches, we are going to neglect the stress concentration. So that was the basics behind all the assumptions that we make for solid mechanics analysis. Now, in our next part, we are going to discuss the types of load and what are the sign conventions of those loads. Thank you for watching.